Yo, what's going on YouTube? It's your boy Master Monkey here, and today I'm going to be showing you guys how to put together your HD60 Elgato capture card to run it from your PS5 to your PC so you can stream all your PS5 gameplay to your PC. It's a simple, fast process. I'm going to show you guys how to exactly get it done. Stay tuned. Alright guys, it's a simple process. All you need is the Elgato comes with the HD capture card. Also comes with the HDMI cable and the Elgato power cable. So you really need is your PS5 HDMI cable. And don't forget, for this, you're gonna make sure it's a USB 3 power port. So then HDMI cable for your PS5 or Xbox, I'm using a PS5. And then your PC. My PC is on the floor, so I'm gonna hook it up right now. All right, so you got your Elgato, right? First thing first, you're gonna turn to your inside. And go to your inside, grab one of your HDMI cables, it doesn't matter which one, and then you're gonna stick it in. And this first HDMI cable is gonna go into your PS5, PS4, or Xbox, or whatever. All right, after you guys got that installed, next thing you're gonna do is install your power cable. So your power cable is right here on the inside as well. And this, you're gonna be hooking up to your PC. It's also a USB 3 port, so make sure that whenever you're plugging it in, it's gonna be for USB 3. All right, once you got it hooked up to your USB port, you should have seen a light pop on. Once that light pops on, indicating that you're now getting power to it. Next, you're gonna flip it out to your outside. For your outside, that's the USB or the HDMI cable you're gonna be used to hook up to your monitor, your PC, or whatever you're using to, you know, play your broadcast, your game on. Once you hook it up, press connect. On your screen, what you wanna do is go to your settings and go to system, HDMI, and make sure you disable HDCP. That's the only way it's gonna work. You have to disable this first. If you disable this first, and then it should work with no problem. If you're still having some issues, then make sure you go back and disable this right here. So after you got everything installed, go to your PC and then go to your internet browser and then go to Elgato download video capture, should pop up downloads. Something like this, allow. So we're gonna select our product. We're using Windows, so we're gonna select Windows account. And it tells you what kind of capture card you got. So I got an HD60 S. It varies for which ones you're installing and which ones you have installed to your, that you guys got for your preference. So we go in the HD60, and we wanna get the game capture. So we hit download, save file. And as you can see, it only takes a few seconds for you to download. All right, once it's done installing, it should be one of these icons on the tab. Go ahead and double click it. Should be opening it up. Once it opens up, your game should be able to display it. All right, for settings, if it doesn't pop up and you're hooking up to a PS5, go through your settings, go to capture. They have different series or different, you know, systems on here that's gonna be captured. Make sure you are using the same system that you are gonna be using. For me, I'm using the HDMI capture. There's an analog capture on here. If you wanna use the analog, you can. You just gotta hook up your PS5 controller to your analog, to the HDMI cable or the capture card, and it should be able to work. I like to run an HD 1080p because I want it everything to be looking crisp and clear for my streams and for my videos. That's what helps me out the most. For quality, I go with best because, you know, like I said, I want to try to get the best quality videos for you guys. And yeah, that's pretty much it. Picture, you know, you can play with your contrast and stuff. I kept my same audio. I didn't really change too much of the audio. And that's about it. Cancel. So yeah, once you guys got your HDCP disconnected and disabled from your PS5, PS4, you should be able to see your display on the capture. As you can see in the background, I am running no lag. There's really no drop frames, no nothing. It's actually pretty smooth. Even if I go play and hopped in the game, there's no lag between the controllers, between the PC. Everything's running smooth. You could be able to hook up to your streams and display, and you know, run. You could run dual streams if you want. You could stream off your PS5 and then stream off your PC. So if you want to stream on two different platforms, you're more than able to. Look at that, no lag. Tapping the controller, and it's still on beat. Well, I hope you guys enjoy the stream. I hope you guys found this video informative. You know, you can always catch me live with more up to date. If you guys like to see more content like this, be sure to drop a like and hit that subscribe button. Or you can follow me over at twitch.com/massivemonkey. And catch you guys next time.